Yes, I'm really touched and really inspired by the story of Ruth Matete. Ruth Matete, wherever you are watching us today, may God use you. May He use you for His glory. Whether you're preaching the word, wherever you're going, whatever you do, let it bring glory to God. Yes, and allow yourself to be used by God. I'm so blessed to hear such stories, such good stories. Encourage me to never give up, to actually hold on and push on and fight for the glory of God. And tunapeleka injili mbele, tusongesha injili mbele. Yes, another inspiration vibe. It's time for inspiration vibe. Inspiration vibe. Tulianza hii inspiration vibe last Sunday. We were like, we're going to challenge ourselves this year. At least whatever amount of time we take. Whether it's 10 minutes, whether it's 5 minutes, whether it's 2 minutes, whether it's a whole hour. Hey, I remember Pastor T, I'm a Mr. T, as we all know him. He was saying like, there are people who even pray for like 8 hours straight. They're just praying and reading the word of God. So whatever amount of time we take, we're going to challenge ourselves this year. So let us start with 10 minutes challenge, yeah, on reading the word of God. And you know, guys can be, at least, can be, wanaweza kuwa shaky, wanashanga, ay, how does this Bible, this ancient word, actually apply to the current life? You know, times have changed, yeah? So you wonder, how does it apply to me, yeah? And I will take you to Second Timothy, that is, 2 Timothy chapter 3, 16 to 17, which says, yeah, all scripture is God-breathed and is useful for teaching, rebuking, correcting, and training in righteousness, so that the man of God may be thoroughly equipped for every good work, yeah? So it still applies to us right now, for teaching, for rebuking, for correcting, yeah, for training, for His righteousness, so that we can be made righteous, yeah? So it still apply, yeah? So my question to you this morning, do you actually desire to be soaked and to be lost in the presence of the Lord, just reading the word? Ukisikia tu hizo maneno mazuri mazuri yanakueleza juu yako. All that is in the Bible. Do you actually desire that? Yeah? All those things. And why is it so important to actually soak in the word of God, yeah? We'll find that in Matthew chapter 4. Chapter 4, verse 4, which says, Jesus answered, it is written, man shall not live on bread alone, but on every word that comes from the mouth of God. Yeah, this is Jesus being tempted by the enemy. So, unashangawa, is it so important for me to be reading the word of God, to be taking, to be sparing 10 minutes of my time, or 5 minutes of my time, or even 2 hours of my time reading the word of God? Yeah, why is it so important? You know, this. You as a man, you are 3-in-1. You are like, you have the flesh, you have the soul, and you have the spirit. Yo. So, unaona mwili yako, that is the flesh. If you don't feed it, usipokula, let me tell you, you'll be so weak and be so hungry that you'll not be able to do duties. It's the same way with our spirit, yeah? So if we don't feed our spirit, and the only way we can feed our spirit is through reading the word of God. So if we don't feed our spirit man, we'll be so weak in times of difficulties. The adult will be unable to withstand any difficult. You'd be so unable to withstand all that. But when you read the word of God, you become strong. When you eat, ukikula chakula, you are strong in flesh. The same way our spirit works. So if you feed our spirit with the word of God, yeah, reading the word of God daily, praying daily, and just listening to His word, we'll grow strong in the word of God. So when the challenges, when the storms of this life comes, we are strong enough to face them. Yeah, because when we read the word of God, we get to know that God is with us. He's our help. He's our strong tower. His hand is upon us, that nothing will attack us. Nothing will be against us. We are conquerors. We are victors when we are not losers. All this is in the word of God. So we need to read the word of God to get to know what it is about us. So we need to be deep rooted in the word so that you'll not be easily tossed around when we get the temptations and all in the times of difficulties. Also, we gain knowledge. Another importance is that we gain knowledge, yeah? We gain knowledge by reading the word of God. And let me tell you something, yeah? The enemy knows. He knows what God is saying about you in the word of God. So, kuna vile hata to distract. That's why it's crazy. Kila mtu anashindanga tu WhatsApp, Instagram, Facebook, Twitter. Umeshinda tu kwa mtandao. Umeshinda umehang out na mabeste. So, you have no time to read the word of God. Sikuile unafunguanga Bible ni sikuile unaendanga Sunday. That is once a month unaendanga church. Or during Christmas Day. Unapata Bible kakona kavumbi, unapuliza. Design ya jabidi. really. So this year, let us create a culture of opening the Word of God to gain that knowledge that will change our attitude. You know, our attitude is actually, it is determined. Our attitude is determined by what the kind of information we consume. Huh? So when we consume good things of the Lord in the Word of God, yeah, in our Bible, our attitude changes. We become victors. Unakuwa mshindi, as in just our attitude changes to better, yeah. So reading the Word of God helps us to know God in a deeper way, yeah. Another importance, we get to know God in a deeper way when we read the Word of God. It draws us closer to God. So God, if God says, nothing will separate me from nothing will separate you from the love of God. Nothing. Even when you sin, God still loves you. Hey, mazi, see, your attitude will change. You'll just know, nimekosea hapa. Let me go back and repent because God loves me and nothing will separate me. That's the kind of information and attitude we need to have in 2020, yeah? So every day we need to read the Word of God. You learn something different, yeah? Because when we read the Word of God, you learn something different. Because kuna vile utasoma hii verse leo, ukikuja kusoma kesho, it will be totally different. There will be a different understanding. But either way, it's still the Word of God. So whatever revelation you get, please embrace it, yeah? So you must, so whatever meaning you get, do not stop reading the Word of God, because the Word of God grows us. It draws us close to God. So baby steps. Ata ukisahau leo, kesho, start all over again, yeah? Ukisahau 2 weeks, start all over again. You are allowed to start all over again reading the Word of God. So do not forget, what matters is consistent, persistence, and discipline when it comes to reading the Word of God. So nikifanya tu recap ya the last month, tulisema our prayers are effective. We're gonna show random kinds of random acts of kindness, and you see, we're going to read the Word of God. Yeah, so this year we should be equipped, fully equipped to face 2020. Praise God, guys. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. I hope you've learned something. Yes, and on that note, tunamaliza inspiration vibe, okay? So if you want to know God, read the Word of God. If you want to be drawn closer to God, Biblia, ndo msema ukweli, yeah? Guys, let DJ Nick play us one song, two songs, three songs.